Welcome back, folks. Earlier this month, I put up a poll in my Discord server asking you guys to vote for your favorite new wave of British heavy metal albums. So in today's video, we're going to go through the results of that vote and see what albums that you guys hold as the top 25 new album albums. And I've only allowed British full-length albums released between 1979 and 1986. And I've also decided to exclude bands of the first wave here, so there won't be any Priest, Budgie, Magnum or Motorhead in this video, simply because none of them were new album in my opinion, even if they were active during the same time. And I've also decided to exclude bands like Hell and Pagan Altar that were around during the wave, but they didn't release anything until way later. And before we get into the top 25 new album albums list, make sure to smash that like button and subscribe if you're new to the channel. Because now, it's time for us to check out the top 25 new album albums, as voted by you viewers. We'll be right back.
have no choice. Standing to attention, waiting for his master's voice.
We'll be right back. to be an iron horse 20 years ago. Used to bring the mail to me through the ice and snow. I've sat alone and watched her steaming through the night. 90 tons of thunder.
You know so well, I will take you to a
And here we have it, the top 25 new wave of British heavy metal albums, as voted by you viewers. And it was a bit of a surprise to me to see Satan win this vote with Court and Act. Don't get me wrong, it's an amazing record, but I expected Maiden to win this vote, or perhaps Saxon, or maybe even Angel Witch debut to take the first spot here. So this was a pleasant surprise for me. Another surprise was to see the Number of the Beast down at 24th place. But when it comes to bands that put out several records during the wave, bands like Maiden, Saxon, Raven or Tank, their votes can be spread over several records. So it might be easier for a band that just put out an album or two while the new wave of British heavy metal lasted. At least that's my take on these results. And we also have a lot of honorable mentions here, albums that you guys voted for, but they didn't make it into our top 25 list. Albums like Praying Mantis, Time Tell No Lies, Holocaust, The Nightcomers, and Witchfinder General's Friends of Hell all barely missed the top 25 list. And we also have albums like Iron Maiden's Peace of Mind, Def Leppard's High and Dry, Girls' School's Hit and Run, and other albums from Tank, Saxon, Tigers of Pantang, Samson and Witchfind. I've also put together a list of my top 25 favorite new album albums, and this is of course incredibly hard to do, and I didn't go back and analyzed each album, I made this list in like 5 minutes, but if I would go back and listen to these albums again, my list may change a bit, but for now I'm happy with it. So here's my personal top 25 list. My favorite new album is Angel Witch debut. It's one of my all-time favorite metal albums, in fact. And we also have Grim Reaper's See You in Hell, Satan's Court in the Act, and Diamondhead's Lightning to the Nations. And we have a lot of Maiden, Saxon, and Raven on my list as well. And it's debatable whether Deep Switch, 9 Inches of God, and Iron Maiden's Power Slave are real new albums. But I have allowed albums released between 79 and 86 in this video. But the new wave of British heavy metal wasn't just studio albums, so I'm thinking that we need to vote for the best new album singles as well. So if you're into that and want to lay your vote, make sure to join the Discord server through my Patreon page. And speaking of Patreon, if you want to support my work and get access to the most ruthless of Discord servers, then you should consider becoming a Patreon, like the Horsemen of the Apocalypse. And I'm also on Instagram, Facebook, Spotify, and you can find all the necessary links listed down below. And that's all for now, so thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye bye!